Thank you and good morning, everyone. I will take the next 15 minutes to share with you the story of Graincorp and how we're performing. If we just move beyond the disclaimer to the agenda, I'll talk about who we are. I'll reflect on our financial year 22 performance, and I just want to highlight that our financial year largely follows the harvest and the export program. So it's an October to September year. So very recent results we've just announced and record results, as you'll see. Importantly, those results are on strategy. We are doing what we said we would, and we're delivering against a strategy that we think makes sense and gives us a right to win. And I'll close with some comments on outlook and conclusion. Before I start, though, I do just want to acknowledge the Gadigal people of the Eora Nation, the traditional custodians of the land on which I'm presenting from here in Sydney today, and we pay our respects to their elders past, present, and emerging. So just a little bit about Graincorp. You can all follow the slide on the screen. You can read it as quickly as I can. So perhaps I'll draw out some of the key words that we think define Graincorp and certainly are inherent in the strategy I'll share with you today. Words such as sustainability and the opportunity that sustainability and decarbonisation creates, not just for Graincorp, but for the agriculture sector generally. Innovation is a key part of that. It's a key part of Graincorp, the strategy and the results we're currently delivering. Connection is another word that you'll see on this page and throughout the presentation. And connection occurs in many ways, whether it be the rural and regional communities we work with across Australia, New Zealand, and Canada, or more particularly the fact that we connect more than 12,000 growers, 50 countries around the world to sell their grain and the products that we handle for them. At the heart, though, of our business, we really are an integrated network of high quality infrastructure assets. And you'll see that come through again as I progress through the presentation. Just looking at about Graincorp, there's some key headlines here. We own and operate seven deep sea bulk ports across the east coast of Australia. They are the green dots on the map that you can see to the right hand side of this slide. We have over 160 sites receiving, storing and handling grain for growers across the grain belt of Victoria, New South Wales and Queensland. We have a range of storage facilities and a feeds business across both Australia and New Zealand, and a joint venture in Canada, which gives us good insights and opportunity to originate from that very important market globally. Our offices are based around the world, giving us connection with the markets in which we trade, both from a demand point of view, but also insights into the supply picture around the world. Ultimately, Graincorp's operating in very favourable fundamentals of a growing population, urbanisation and demand outstripping supply for our products. The other aspect of our business is we do operate an integrated end-to-end supply chain, or as we call it, a value chain. It goes to that commentary I made about connection, the fact that our international team are connecting with countries and customers in over 50 countries around the world. That extends right across our various segment reports, our agribusiness and our processing, which are broken down into the East Coast business, which is the largest grain storage and handling network on East Coast of Australia. We're the largest and leading oilseed crusher in Australasia, producing a range of edible oils, fats, margarines, and spreads and applications for food businesses, including our own. And we close that cycle with our feeds, fats, and oils business, which is delivering incredibly interesting opportunities in the agri-energy space. So just coming to our financial year 22 performance, if we look at it across three key areas, we would describe it as outstanding performance, a record for Graincorp of $703 million in EBITDA. That's off the back of a second consecutive bumper crop on the east coast of Australia, but also strong delivery and outstanding performance throughout the business. I think the return on invested capital at 27.9% really underpins the strength of that result. and the disciplined approach we have to capital management and recent investment delivering and underpinning those earnings results. That, of course, is delivering significant value to shareholders, dividends of over $121 million in financial year 22, including the, or in addition to that, of course, the $50 million share buyback that we completed, and a very strong balance sheet at $177 million of core cash. We are well positioned to invest in growth and deliver shareholder returns now and into the future. This slide, I like to think, speaks for itself. It covers the headlines: $703 million in earnings, up from $331 million the prior year. Net profit after tax, $380 million, up from $139. I've talked on the return on invested capital at 27.9. The very strong performance through the business with 41.1 million tonnes of grain handled, 471,000 tonnes of oilseed crushed, and a very strong balance sheet at $177 million in core cash. What I'd say is that we are controlling the things that we can control. We're delivering outstanding execution across the business, and that's giving us the opportunity to make the most of the conditions that exist in the market around the world. We are also building on our sustainability commitment. You'll see sustainability mentioned throughout our strategy and the strong overlap between both our commitments and the opportunity that we see in sustainability for the ag sector. At the same time as our annual results, we've launched for the 10th year in a row now our sustainability report. In that report, we map our scope 3 emissions and make commitments to accelerate our delivery against decarbonisation by 2030. We see huge opportunity to work with the sector on the big areas of transport and fertiliser use in those scope 3 areas, as well as the things that we're doing within GrainCorp and the investments we've made in innovation that could be game changers. Our ESG overall strategy, of course, applies to our people as well and is underpinned by strong governance, including the establishment of a board subcommittee on sustainability over the second half of this last financial year. In our strategy, I've shared right at the start of the presentation our vision and our purpose. And then if you look at the strategic priorities, they are deliberately split into two clear parts, what we call strengthening the core, and then to the right-hand side, the targeted growth opportunities. And I'll talk through both of these areas, but they are about making sure that we deliver on that commitment to lift return on invested capital and drive our existing assets harder, whilst also identifying and delivering on growth areas where we have a right to win. That strategy is not just about GrainCorp in isolation. It draws on what we see as key macro trends around the world and really the intersection between where GrainCorp operates and the exciting opportunities these trends create. We see a growing population and changing demographics. That's giving us at GrainCorp the opportunity to originate grain from different parts of the world to ensure we can provide reliable supply to our customers across the globe, but principally in Asia, where we have a geographic proximity advantage versus many other supply areas. Decarbonisation and sustainability will be a key part of what we do now and into the future. Disrupted global supply chains have been a factor around the world, and I think the resilience of GrainCorp's end-to-end supply chain, the fact that we've been able to move record volumes and deliver record results, speaks to the capability we have in our business, it speaks to the people, and it speaks to the design of our network and the end-to-end consideration we have in getting grain to customers around the world. We're also accelerating our use of technology, digital and advanced analytics to improve the performance and efficiency of our supply chain and lift the customer interactions that we have. So we are really strongly positioned to take a leading position in the food and agriculture sector in these areas. I'm not going to spend a lot of time going through every pillar on this page. What I would describe this page as is doing what we said we would. This reflects back on a commitment we made 18 months ago in an investor presentation to lift our underlying earnings by 40 million by 23-24. And we're confirming that we've delivered on that commitment already, and we're highlighting the specific areas that lead to that commitment: diversifying the use of our assets, better asset utilization, full expansion of our international strategy in the Canadian market, lifting our capabilities and driving customer experience. Moving across to the areas that we see as interesting for growth, they cover animal nutrition, alternative or plant-based protein, agri-energy, and digital and ag tech and grower services. So they're all areas that GrainCorp already operates in. And just to give you some examples of the sorts of areas that we're investing in and why we're excited about the growth that these themes present for GrainCorp, it's areas like sustainable feed solutions, our investment in Future Feed, which is there to commercialize the addition of asparagopsis to feed regimes for cattle and sheep and other animals, improving productivity, massively reducing methane emissions. So that's innovation that's been spun out of CSIRO, and GrainCorp's proud to be a foundation shareholder in that business. In plant-based proteins, we already handle many of the raw materials that go into the ingredients for plant-based proteins. We operate a crushing business, crushing oilseed, which is the same sort of technology to produce protein. We'd like to see opportunities to increase the value of the canola meal we produce and turn that into ultimately a protein suitable for human and food consumption. But in addition to that, we have some really exciting innovation underway and delivering value already, producing the fats for a whole food. So if you're producing an alternative plant-based burger patty, not only do you need the plant-based protein, but you need the fat complexes that go into that. And GrainCorp already makes those plant-based fat products. Agri-energy is incredibly exciting. We're seeing strong growth in our renewable fuel feedstock business, our Auscoal oil recycling or upcycling business, as we like to call it, and the much stronger correlation in recent years between edible oil prices and fuel prices around the world. It's a market that we expect to grow strongly and create great opportunities for Australia and GrainCorp specifically. Through the year, we launched our GrainCorp Ventures. That gives us the opportunity to ring fence investment in technology, learn as we go, but also be part of the upside for the sector that technology and digital in particular will bring. And on our grower services side, increasing the length of engagement we have with growers is all about our promise to deliver on service levels to growers throughout the year. So if I just move across to our outlook and conclusion, we are delivering significant value to shareholders. In the financial year 2022, our final dividend is a fully franked dividend of 30 cents. That makes dividends for the full year 54 cents on top of the $50 million share buyback that we completed earlier in the calendar year. There's therefore $171 million in capital returned through financial year 22, and further capital management opportunities in the future, given the strong profitability of the business over the last couple of years and in our outlook period. If you look at the dividend there, you can see the chart on the right, the very strong confidence we have in the ordinary dividend, reflecting the fact of strong underlying earnings and above average earnings into the future. If we look at our outlook for financial year 23, I'll start at the bottom of the page. Each year we provide guidance at our AGM in February of each year. So our AGM is coming up on the 16th of February. And the reason for that timing of the guidance is by then we'll have full confidence over the current harvest. I would say, though, that as we announced our results of 2-3 weeks ago now, ABARES had the fourth highest estimate for the winter crop at 27 million tonnes. Just today, they've come out with their December update, effectively holding flat, 26.9 million tonnes, and acknowledging that as tough as flooding has been on individual farmers, the overall picture for East Coast of Australia still looks incredibly strong and well above the average of around 20 million. That's playing out in the way we're seeing harvest develop. We're seeing very strong harvest receivables come in. And certainly the last 2 or 3 weeks of fine sunny weather has been something that growers will be enjoying, and we're seeing the benefits of that in GrainCorp. And the outlook over the next few weeks looks good for a strong ongoing harvest period. We are supporting growers through the logistical challenges presented by flooding, and we expect the harvest to be delayed, which we've seen. Whilst it's progressing well now, we expect it to continue well into calendar 23. So we expect to be receiving grain through January and February in 2023. We have seen some moderation of the exceptional margins achieved in the first half of financial year 2022. Notwithstanding that, very strong margins in the second half, and the underlying conditions supporting those margins are expected to prevail into 2023. Really, the way I would describe that is we're fundamentally operating in a world where there's a shortage of supply and excess demand, and that creates great opportunities for GrainCorp and Australian grain generally. So just in conclusion, Ian, before I hand back to you for any questions, record results for GrainCorp in financial year 2022. We are delivering on our commitments, doing what we said we would. We're delivering and executing our strategy. So we're making the most of the opportunities that exist and building a stronger business. And that is generating significant value for shareholders now and indeed into the future.